For real inner products, we saw that there was a really close connection between the length of a vector and the inner product. We'd like to do the same thing for complex inner products, but first we have to understand what length means in the simplest case, which is cn. You see, for ordinary real numbers, we had that the length of a real number, that's its absolute value. And we could get that by the square root of x squared. And if we were an Rn, then the Pythagorean theorem tells us that the length of a vector is the square root of x1 squared plus x2 squared up to xn squared. And that was the square root of x dotted into x, where we use the standard inner product. Now, we'd like to have an inner product on Cn which has the same property. We'd like to say that the length of a vector in Cn is the inner product of the square root of the inner product of that vector with itself. And to do that, we first have to understand what the left-hand side means, and then we can define the right-hand side appropriately. And we're going to start with the very simplest case of Cn, which is where we only have one complex number. So let's look at a complex number. Typical complex number, it can be written as a plus bi. So we draw the complex plane, the real axis, the imaginary axis, and here's our point a plus bi. And we sometimes do geometry. We call this angle the argument of x. And then this distance here, we call that the length of x. And of course, by the Pythagorean theorem, that length is the square root of a squared plus b squared. Okay, well, a useful quantity to look at is the complex conjugate of x. The complex conjugate is just the same number, only you flip the sign of the imaginary part. Instead of taking a plus bi, you take a minus bi. And you notice that if you multiply the conjugate x bar by x, well, a minus bi times a plus bi, you FOIL it. First is a squared, outside is abi, inside is minus bia, and outside and last is minus b squared I squared. These two terms cancel. I squared is negative 1, and you get a squared plus b squared. So you don't get the length squared by multiplying x by itself. You get the length squared by multiplying the conjugate of x by x. If you'd looked at x squared, that would have given you a squared minus b squared plus 2abi, and that's useless for these purposes. What you really want is x bar times x, not the square root of x squared. Okay, so that's for one complex number. How about if we're in Cn? Well, if we're in Cn, then our typical vector has n entries, and each one is a complex number. And we want the length of that. Well, Pythagoras tells us again, it's x1 squared plus x2 squared plus xn squared. And when I say x1 squared, I don't mean the complex number x1 times itself. I mean the length of x1 squared. That is, a1 squared plus b1 squared, and then you add a2 squared plus b2 squared, and an squared plus bn squared. And that's exactly what you get when you take x1 bar times x1 plus x2 bar times x2, all the way up to xn bar times xn. Okay. Well, this suggests a definition of what our complex inner product should be. Our complex inner product, we will define it to be the inner product of x with y is x1 bar y1 plus x2 bar y2 up to xn bar yn. Now, it's really tempting. The most common mistake that people make when dealing with complex inner products is they forget to put the bars on them. It's not x1 y1, it's x1 bar y1. You got to take the complex conjugate of x1, of x2, of xn, and so on. And that way, if you take the inner product of x with itself, you get x1 bar x1 plus x2 bar x2 plus xn bar xn, and that's the length of x squared. So this is the definition that works. Now, I do warn you, there are some people who put the bar on y instead of on x. I am going to always use this convention, putting the bar on x instead of y. In general, mathematicians tend to put the bar on the second factor. Physicists always put the bar on the first factor. Throughout my book and throughout these lectures, I'm always going to follow the physics convention and put the bar on the first vector.